Hello friends, so today we're going to do a start off, a kickoff on the series on React Native. And really the app that we're going to make is my app that I have here on the Play Store. It's also on the iTunes App Store, and that's what we're going to create. And hey look, it's me on the picture. But anyways, we're really just going to focus on the front end. On the back end, that might be a different story. This is proprietary code, so it's really there for to help you learn. I'm pretty much made this through my own fumbling around with React Native and got everything to work. So it might not be the proper way, but if you ask yourself the question, is there really a proper way of coding? And I mean, everybody have their own coding styles. So you could use this as kind of like a boilerplate or a template in order to help you get started with React Native. This is really something that you can use if you're a beginner or if you're advanced. If you're an advanced, then you probably have your own way of doing things. So really beginner to intermediate is what I'm targeting. It is really just something to, like I said again, it's really something to help you kick yourself off with starting to build an app and trying to go through quickly all the little weird peculiarities that I went through while I was trying to create my own app. So that's pretty much the app that we're going to create on the front end. Like I said again, I'm not sure what we're going to do on the back end. I do have a back end, but it's really long-winded and I made it in Go, and I really need to remember how I made it in the first place. So with that said, let's start off. We are going to use Expo. That's one thing for sure, because I found it to really accelerated my development and to get my app out and running and released as soon as possible. It only took me like 2 months. So we're gonna start off with Expo. Let's take a look. These two sites are what we're gonna use for installation. If you haven't already, I have. Please run this code, npm install -g expo CLI. It will help you install the CLI on your computer for Expo. And once you've done that, you can, yeah, this stuff is pretty much installing the simulators for Android and iOS on your computer. So today's video is going to be pretty much this introduction, actually, and it's going to be a really short expo init of our project. So what I want to do is, let me just bring this over to this screen. I don't know why it's running away, because we need our terminal. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back and run expo init to create our project. You can see that I'm on this Dancingnomads, which is my main folder for my project. It doesn't have your project doesn't have to be there. It could be anywhere, as long as you can do an expo init, which is if you've installed it, you could do it anywhere. So what we're gonna do is you could see what's in here. No, that's not what you could see what's in here by doing an ls. So that's what's in there. So you could do an expo init to create your project first. I go with blank. You could do whatever you want, but for our purposes, we're gonna go with blank. It's gonna make you name your project. I'm just gonna name Dancing Nomads Mobile 2 and give it the slug, which let's give it the same slug, Dancing Nomads Mobile 2, and press enter. If you have dependencies, you can click yes or no, it doesn't really matter. I have, so then I'm just going to install the dependencies and we're just going to watch this run. So I'm just going to pause this video just so you guys don't have to sit around and watch us install. Okay, so you can see that we've installed things. So if I do a ls right now, you can see that I have Dancingnomads Mobile 2. What we're going to do is we're going to cd into that, and not that one, that's my other project, Dancingnomads Mobile 2. And if I do a ls, this is what is automatically created for us. And what I'm going to do here is I am going to actually create a source folder. So what you want to do is do a make dir src, and pretty much what we're going to do is we're going to move some files into that source folder. So things like package.json, app.json, We're probably going to move that all into that source folder. So let's do ls. So we've created our source folder. Let's move what's in that package.json. Let's do a git diff. Well, actually, that won't do anything. Let's do a cat. So running expo init has created everything that you see there in that package.json. And if we do cat on app.json, that's what is created. Okay, so let's move that in there. Move package.json into source. And let's also move the app.json into source. Okay, so now that we've created our source folder, let's cd into it. And we're going to edit those two files. So actually, this is what we kind of have from using one of my templates. So app.json is supposed to look like this. Let's see if it actually looks like that. If I did the cat. Okay, so we just want to make sure that the name, the slug, and everything is okay. Oh, the SDK version got updated. So yeah, everything looks good with the default app.json. For the package.json though, we do have some things that we want to change. So let's go to vim package.json. And you can see that we have some scripts that are automatically made and some dependencies. Let's add in those dependencies that we have. So I'm using Sentry for error logging. So we want that. We want the Axios. I think they already have Expo in there. So let's do this. Expo, and I'm also using Firebase. So let's try to make everything the same. I think moment was for time stuff, like dates. So we're gonna put that there. Native base is pretty much like CSS if you do any web programming, which you probably do if you're doing this. React, React DOM, React Native. We have React Native Axios, the keyboard over scroll view, navigation, and Redux. So let's throw all this in here as well. And Redux, Redux Form, Redux Logger, Redux Sega, Redux Sega Firebase. So let's just throw these in there as well. I'm not even sure if I actually used them all, but they're on there. We have Babel preset expo and remote Redux dev tools. So those are the ones that I have in my project that is live right now. So that's what we're copying from. So with that said, I'm just going to leave it there. We're going to do WQ to exit out of that. And since we have proper package.json, what I want you to do is run an npm install to install all those dependencies. And I'm not going to make you watch this, so that's where I'm going to end the video. When it finishes installing, then you know just run into it'll just give you another prompt for the next command. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this setup, and I hope you continue watching with us on what we're going to build. It's going to be like 50 episodes probably, so look forward to it. Please share and subscribe if you haven't already to help other developers if they're also looking to start React Native from scratch. And a lot of people give Expo a bad rap, but I found it extremely useful for what we are going to do. So anyways, that's it for today. I'll see you guys next time.